Hey. Alright. A little bit surprised to see another part for this, aren't you? Yeah. Two double features in a row. I'm not too surprised, because I was musing Monday, thinking that, or last week, thinking that, you know, I wouldn't be able to do the last, or the Back Hero Chronicles, and here I am, because, I don't know, I'm not gonna think about that, because it's actually kind of makes me a little bit angry. I just want to think about Fire Emblem now. My mind off of the fact that I wasn't really able to do what I wanted to do. So I'm gonna do this. Now I know for a fact that I went over the story for this, so. I'm not gonna repeat that. Alright. Here's something that I should point out, I feel. Originally in the NES version of this, you would get this would be like an actual unique character, and you'd be able to recruit him. And you'd recruit him by going to like one of the villages and talking to a certain character. And you'd go back here, and he would join you. Like you have to go to him as like Cheetah, I think. These guys are kind of a pain in the ass. I mean, they suck at hitting things, especially the folks with, like, the stone hoists. This person with quick rain is a little bit more accurate and a bit more of a pain in the ass, because he uses a weapon that can actually hurt our flyers quite a bit. Now, these guys just kind of suck, but I mean, honestly, though, it only does like 3 extra damage over this one, because the effectiveness just says how much damage he'll do once you, you know, minus the subtraction from the opposing unit's defense. So I'll do 19 minus like Cheetah's defense, and it wouldn't affect her when she's unmounted either, so you can honestly just have them approach on foot and it'd be fine. In fact, you could, like, if you really, really wanted to, if you're really daring, you could get, like, I would honestly use Minerva for it, though, because, like, actually, no, it'd be about the same, because her defense would be lowered to 8, but if you unmount them, you know, and then have them attack, then they wouldn't be affected too much. Alright, but anyway, as I think I pointed out before, what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna get into here. I think the best way to do that, there's like a few options we have. You can either bring some units along this path, this really narrow path, but they're gonna be slowed down tremendously. Because of these forest tiles. Or we can have them move up through here, but then they're gonna be at risk of being attacked by these flyers. Wield javelins. Like, the stone hoists can't really hit us because they don't have enough range. Like, I mean, they have a lot of range, but, like, they can... But they can't move. They don't have any movement. As you can see here. So they're just stuck where they are. I mean, they're real sitting ducks, especially when they... Especially once we actually get there and start killing them off, then they just can't handle it. But we're gonna have to get... In any case, we're gonna have to get here for the village. Like, a third option would also be to send a flyer down here. Funny thing is that, in spite of the fact that these guys are level 5, we gain the same amount of experience from them as we do from, like, level 3 mercs. It really does not matter. We just have slightly higher stats, is all. But let's get this... let's get this started. I'm glad that the DS remakes did is they made it so that Minerva can use axes. Or, you know, Dragon Knights can use axes. Well, that means that the Pegasus Knights lose a weapon. They don't get to use swords at all. They can only use lances in the DS remakes unless you... I would have to look this up. I need to get a drink. Watch out for these risks if you're a woman over 40. More fucking drivel or articles that I'm seeing as I go on the internet. Now, the Falcon Knights are able to use... They're able to use lances. Alright, now we need to organize their weaponry, I think. Weaponry and their equipment. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe I won't. Nah. No, I don't really need to, I don't know why Julian, of all people, is carrying door keys. He really does not need them. Oh, I didn't realize I could just click Y, I think, on them. I and look at their stats that way. Shit. I remember I was trashing on the end of, on the fact that I wasn't able to do that, but then turned out that I was wrong. I could look at what they did. It's just I had to press. I was so used to how more recent Fire Emblems would do it. I couldn't cope. Let's see. I don't know for how much longer I'm gonna be using Doga because he's starting to become more and more irrelevant. Number of our units are starting to catch up to his defense level, and he's just having a hard time keeping up. Like, Minerva in particular is, you know, pretty much on par with his stats. Item. I actually don't remember it being I don't remember it being that powerful, but yeah, any units that's having like serious problems with their speed, just hand it over to them. But I'm gonna wait until all the units I'm using are promoted before I consider using it. Actually, Rena could promote if she had the correct item, which she doesn't. I don't know. I don't remember what item one needs for that. We're getting close to a point where someone's gonna get replaced. I'm thinking that someone's gonna be Bart's because I do not use Axemen that much. They have to be able to use a different weapon as well. And quite frankly, I don't think the Axe Fighters in this game can promote anyway. I mean, I'll have to look at, yeah, they can. They don't promote. There was a berserker class in this game that used swords. Yeah, So of the team we have, the only ones that can't promote are Marth, Banatu, Julian, and the Barts. At least the ones that we're actually using. There's more that can't promote that are. Well, and technically Minerva can't promote either, but she's. That's because she's kind of. She's technically a promoted unit already. She's probably gonna be eating most of the stat boosters. And actually, speaking of Minerva, I might not want to rely on her too much yet, because she only has like 18 levels before she's maxed out. Like everyone else, except for Marth and Banatu and Barts, they all have an extra 20 levels. Aside from like their current levels up to level 20, like they can level up to 20. And then you can promote them, and they'll have another 20 levels to go. But anyway, let's get this started. Man, I forgot there's dialogue. I don't know if I'm able to do very good voice acting. Nina. We'll be able to see Pales very soon. I must hold such painful memories for you. Oh, Pales. I can still see it in my mind's eye. So many people were killed. Royals were all taken to the castle gate and executed in public as a warning to everyone. After managing to escape, I turned back to see father and mother. They're no longer what they used to be. Brought such terrible shock to me. I wanted to cry, but nothing came out. All I felt was sorrow and regret. That was already in the past. Now is not the time to be reminiscing. Go, Marth, to the streets where I was born, to Akaneia's royal capital of Pales. Yeah, so we're at a major turning point here. But you can't see the. But yeah, like, literally, they cannot move. But they have a range, they have a shooting range of 10. So it's from here, or it's 3 to 10. So, you know, they could go anywhere, like, between 3 and 10. Or they can shoot at anything between. From like 3 to 10 spaces away from them. So like from here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and up here, and up here, and up here, and up here. It's like actually they don't have that much range on us. Like they can only get up to like here, and here, and here, and here, and then after that it's just mostly mountains that they'd be shooting at. Because I'm not a total dolt, I'm not gonna have them running up to. I'm not gonna have anyone vulnerable running up to there. Yeah, like we can opt to go along in the path through the mountains. Or I mean in the forest, or we can go through the other path. And honestly, I feel like a little forest stroll might do Sheeta some good. Do it. I don't know, maybe it'll do her really, really badly, actually, but... Oh yeah, we do gotta keep in mind this... this opponent here. I'm sorry, I just wanted to check something. Maybe I don't want to use this too much, but... Honestly, he's at the forefront of my army right now, so I'm gonna turn him into one. And I have to, like, get, round up all the axes and sell them, especially a double axe. I'm not gonna fucking use that. That weapon's recipe for disaster. Alright, let's see what these assholes do. Oh yeah, that's right, of course. Yeah, we gotta get there before that thief does, and I honestly don't think they're gonna get there before we do. So, it's all fine. Oh, but there's also gonna be these horsemen. Good thing we're going two ways. Oh, fuck. I do not like that. I do not like that. This is sniping right there. I'm gonna have to do something about that lady. Alright. Yeah, well, she handles this. Not very well. Okay, very well. Never mind. You hoodlums are no match for the great and terrifying Sheeta. Oh my god. Ah, fuck. Maybe she isn't gonna do so well. Oh hey, she got some defense, maybe it'll be enough to save her from this third guy. As if she needed more defense, by the way. Or, I mean, more speed, by the way. Alright, so... we're not in a good situation. Um, I guess that would be that. Reblow bloke. Yeah, I'm a reblow bloke. Let's see. Kinda want Harden to do this. I'll have Doka hit just to make sure that she doesn't E, I should say. Because this is one of those early Fire Emblem games where it's actually Guy Pegasus Knights. Oh, gee, with all the speed he gets, you'd think he'd have double that guy. Attack speed is still zero, huh? Well, he has just enough defense that this guy will do absolutely nothing. You can do this. Good job, Gordon. I think I would like to level Gordon up at least, though. So we're gonna have this Pegasus Knight running through here. Here, I have another reblow.
Okay.
angry swordman. Mathematics can go up to here. Yeah, here. Store that, and I'll have to take this. Alright, so yeah, this guy's now got 12 defense. He's got effectiveness, 44 damage worth of effectiveness against ice dragons, which is pretty insane. That's an insane amount of effectiveness. Also quite scary. Alright, but let's end the turn. Now that Pegasus Knight is definitely gonna go for one of our units. I'll wait for of course it went for him. That's all it did. Alright, so oh, be careful of the bow, Knight. We are gonna have Sheeta. The houses don't offer anything, so we're gonna have Sheeta go here. Wait. Julian will help. Guess I'll have someone down here. Someone who's capable of two range, such as people with his, trusty javelin. Merrick's close to leveling, but honestly, I think he'd be better served defeating some other type of enemy. All right, Gordon, you do your thing. I swear, if you miss. All right, good job, man. Equipped. Cool beans. Just want to make sure she's ready to kill three more of these guys. It's just a stone voice, okay. Alright, Now you could go there. Alright. That's all I want to do for that turn. Alright, now I gotta get that thief right away. Great. Now these guys are going after. She's gonna kill all of them. And she's probably gonna dodge. I mean, she already dodged one of them. She might dodge at least one other guy. That'd be cool. It'd be even awesomer if she dodged all of them. But nah. I mean, it's still good that she's killing them off. And getting levels in the process. Yeah. Oh, okay, so... this hoodlum's just decided that he doesn't want to mess with this. Now, this thief is dangerously close to getting to the village. Okay. Alright, this is the village.
This is terrible. Since the king here fell, this town has become so desolate.
Okay, cool. Thanks. Thanks for the valuable information. I will be sure to use it in my travels. So as long as no one's like here, here, or here, we should be fine. Kill or hurt, rather. It's not gonna kill, but he'll definitely hurt. Always so exciting to just like set things up just right. Kill. I killed. I did good. Ah, hey, that defense. Good. Good, good. Minerva's the new errand boy. I'm so sorry.
I hate war. It always makes women and children weep. You mustn't continue like this. Head back to your lover's side immediately.
I like how she said that to a woman. In fact, two of the three people that are in here right now are women. There's like one dude and he isn't really visiting the village. Well, actually, no, he is visiting a town. Alright, good. Alright, she got 14 experience to get to level 14. Alright, she's that much closer to being able to use the again staff. I guess that's a goal of mine, I don't know. Have everyone wait in ambush. Yeah, 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 I see you. Alright, dude's going after dude. Let's see how Ogma handled this. Or Navarre, not Ogma. I mean, I did not read the name. Well, Navarre handled it fairly well. Ah, of course. Of course. Why wouldn't he? It's just natural, you know? You know, I'm gonna have Mathematics go and kill this guy. Use the level. He could use a level. Yeah, he'll be able to die. That was an odd way to word that. Yeah, he'll be able to die. Oh, okay. Well, that's enough to level up. Oh, that was an awful level. Oh, that was terrible. That was the worst. Math, why'd you give me such a shitty level? Right, this guy. Obviously, he's gunning for that village. Yeah, he's higher enough. He should be able to kill this guy. That's Julian's main lot in life, is to kill other thieves. Kind of fitting, oddly enough. I mean, he did say that he's fighting for justice. What is more justice-like than killing thieves? Thing is, if you want to use healers, then you're going to want to feed them, like, all the stat boosters. Alright, here comes Angry Man. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's real good. Oh, yeah. Okay, I don't know what use you have for that, because kind of... At least he wasn't using it. Or that, I mean, the Cavalier wasn't using it. Alright, we're gonna have our Cavaliers scout out the town. We're gonna have a little bit of R&R here. Before we go to Pales. Yeah, wait there. Well, she didn't visit the house she's on. Well, she can visit it later. A person can defend themselves against the breath of a dragon. Any armor is useless, so fighting front on is very dangerous. Yeah, so I've learned from this guy.
Right now, evildoers have populated this region. And even walking outside is dangerous.
Well, I kind of took care of that, actually, so... Yeah.
Since ancient times, the Akaneia royal family passed on three special weapons. The fireball, Parthia. The rock. Crushing Lance Gravis and the mythical blade Miracle.
I think that's supposed to be what is that sword again? Hang on. It's localized into something else. Miracle. It's called the Mercurius. That's what it's called. It's called Mercurius. Not Miracle, god damn it.
That carry them will receive the blessing of deities.
Alright. Let's see if the enemy will spawn anyone. Nope. They don't give a shit about their fortifications. Alright, Bantu, I guess you're gonna be relegated to errand duty as well. Just outside this town is the slave market. But it's just full of stray kids. Okay, thanks. Good to know that there's a slave market, like, right outside the capital. Always have to marvel at the fact that there's like a slave market literally right outside the palace. Like, it's just a little stroll down the road, and it's like right there. Yep. Slave market. Just the slave market right there. I don't think I visited this house. This place is Akaneia's Norda Town. The armory and vendor have lots of nice goods. Thanks. I have shit to sell. Let's see, how much is... That seems like too little. Wait. I like to see if I could buy something. They don't have the kind of goods I want. This is the armory. What do you want to do? What would you like? Oh, hey, I could use some of these. I'm going to have to choose an item to send to storage. I'll get like two of them. And I'll get a silver. Just one. I'm just going to buy one. That's it. Slayer. After that, I'm gonna start selling. Pretty much, anyway. Alright, yeah, so we're gonna all. So I'm gonna have everyone just relax for a bit. As mathematics goes and villages. Because we may or may not be getting a new unit this time around. And also, this guy is scary. We need to kill him. I mean, it might be best to send a good old dragon friend down there. Besides the fact that he has tons of defense, he can also fight on even ground with this monster. I mean, look at that fucking face. Oh my god. It's hideous. Alright. Yeah, alright. In the turn. Prince Marth, I am George, a sniper of Akaneia. After the Battle of Pales, I was captured by the Durha Empire, but I managed to escape. When you agreed to protect Nina, I was already here waiting for you. From now on, I will use my silver bow to aid the liberation of my homeland. Got him earlier than I recall. Alright, but this is George. Right now, he's basically a better version of Gordon. In fact, I don't know if Gordon is doing all that well. I guess I'll try to use him a bit more, but... honestly, I think switching over to George might be the best. I mean, no one's under-leveled, really, but I could use money, so... guess I'll do the arena. Oh yeah, this music's slightly different from the,
This is the Colosseum. Do you want to pay the wager of 1,050 gold?
Yeah.
Your enemy is level 3. The price is 2,100 gold. You can only leave by pressing B before the next round begins, or when you win or lose. Try your best not to die.
What the fuck? Are you kidding me? She's not gonna be able to survive this. No. What the fuck?
In that case, I'm keeping the wager.
Fuck you! You just pitted me up against a fucking ice dragon. Eat a dick. Yeah, no, it's just always gonna be the same. Alright, 450. And yeah. Alright. Yeah, that was pretty fucking unfair, I must say. I think there's one that's gonna join that'll be really underleveled. We already have George, and I think George is gonna be better than Gordon, despite the fact that he does have lower growth rates, but honestly, Gordon's only really mostly slightly lower. Like, the biggest growth difference between them is luck. Whew. Yeah, because I'm really hurting for luck here. I mean, okay, to be fair, they both have 4, but still, like, I don't need luck. Alright, everyone's just gonna hang out here. Yeah, that was pretty fucking unfair, I must say. Let's see if Miracle fare any better. You know what? Because that was so unfucking fair, I'm actually gonna. Let's see. Hang on. F4. Fuck, I don't know. that's how I'll do that. When I'm 50 gold. Ah, Jesus. Okay, it's a mage this time. It's actually kind of fair. Kind of. Never mind, it's not fair. Are you kidding me? Really? Come on. I swear, I'm not gonna cheat that much. It's just that the game keeps pitting me up against unfair battles. This fucking Coliseum is bullshit. I'm gonna try one more time. Okay, this is like a little bit more fair. A little bit fairer? No, never mind. Unless she can double him. Yeah, okay. I guess I just need to use fucking Cheetah. I just like the, like, I just always love the way the horse floats, like, it's just kicking wildly. Alright. Alright, here's the next place to go.
You need a slave? Right now, we only have weakling kids for sale, but we could sell them to you for a cheap price.
You are selling children? How dare you! If you want to live, release the children and leave this place at once.
Ah, the Viridian army. Help!
Must have suffered, but it's all right now. Please return safely to your homes.
Why aren't you leaving?
I no longer have a home to go back to.
Huh? You are a girl, but why are you wearing boys' clothing?
I am Bishop Moroa's daughter, Linda. I dressed up as a boy to escape from Garneth, but then I was caught by the slave merchants.
Really?
So you are Moroa's daughter. You can relax now. Nina has also been worried about you. From now on, we will protect you, so you won't be in danger any longer.
No! Lord Marth, I want to fight as well.
I have my father's Aura Tome, which he gave me. As long as Nina permits, I can use it. I want to personally defeat Garneth to avenge my father.
Alright, now we got another mage.
And she got rid of her freckles.
Actually, that is. I actually want to show you something real quick. I think I'll be able to show this anyway. I don't know. Maybe I won't be able to find it. Ah, no, okay. Alright, never mind. But there's, like... What I wanted to show is that there's, like, a... Like, there's a... Like, an opening scene in... Or, like, in Fire Emblem Warriors, there's a... opening for Lind, where she's wearing the robes that allowed her, or that she used to disguise as a boy. I thought it was kind of a cool touch. Alright, but Lind here, Linda, apparently, she's obviously low level, but she has some advantages to her. The main advantage is being that she can get a... Well, for one thing, she's gonna probably wind up with much higher speed than Merrick, and also she'll be able to use certain tomes that Merrick can't. one of those being the Aura tome that she already is carrying. There's also another tome that's pretty useful that she's able to use. Well, and these base stats aren't the worst. I mean, she has pretty crummy defense, but I mean, honestly, mages typically are low defense. I'm gonna see about maybe getting... God, this fucking arena is bullshit. It's so cheap. It really, truly is. So I'm gonna make another save just in case. She has aura and fire. Now, aura is pretty damn powerful. It's also hefty. It's also got a lot of heft to it. Buy her a live staff. Buy her a lizard. $699, oh shit. Got the six number in there. No. Goodbye. Farewell. I'll never talk to you again. This is the Colosseum. Do you want to pay the wager of 640 gold? Your enemy is level 2. Price is about 1280 gold. You can only leap at blah 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 blah. Try your best not to die. Thank you. like, this shit is never fair. It's like, just such bullshit. No, I do not want her to carry that weapon. Harden's been hurt a little bit, but just a little bit. Alright. Oh wow, it's 9:50. Wow. Fuck, I just... I didn't mean to say that. I don't really want to give this like a time that I'm doing it, but whatever. Give Harden an easier time by giving him, yes, Harden. Yeah, it is. Didn't need that too much, but, I like doing a good deed, I guess. Yeah, we're gonna have to be wary of this fucker. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Alright, transform so you can go farther, faster. There he is. There he is, the big bad boy. that. That. You just go forward, I guess. You do that. Oh. Alright, now let's have Mr. Dragon Friend here go over. Go over there. I don't need to worry too much about this stone hoist. It kind of sucks, honestly. I need to be more concerned about this fucking dragon. Mr. Roger Dodger, aka Little Dragon Friend, he's gonna help. Fine. There we go. Now Gorn won't die immediately. Alright, let's get everyone up there. Alright, here we come. I love how it just looks so small. It's just like, oh, it's a little thing. Better watch out. Oopsie. Alright, I'm gonna just burn it down. Burning down the house. There we go. Grunia fell. Now, here's where things are gonna get really interesting. Oh wait, hang on. Supply. Store. Steal. Take. Dragon killer. And trade. Give it to guy has an attack rating of 20, so basically any allied unit that isn't a manic that has less than 20 HP is just gonna straight up die to this guy. Gonna straight up die against the dragon. In other words, I'm pretty sure Navarre will survive. Oh, and if we defeat him, we get a power ring. You know, which we're definitely gonna try to obtain. Great too, because he's gonna wind up landing right on that enemy, right in range of this sniper. And the sniper might not hit him. If that's the case, then we'll have a full, we'll have a full steel bow to use. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if we move someone on that floor, it's gonna be just outside his range. Alright, let's do this. Let's see how this will happen. Look at this. Look at this thing! Well, okay. Didn't look like he dodged that, but, alright. I'll buy it. Let's do some more. Come on. Round two, motherfucker. Oh, shit. Shosen. His name is Shosen. I want to see if I can get, So 35 effective damage against this guy. 23 plus 23. Well, he's also probably gonna crit. Let's do this. Hey, he dodged. Now he's down to 22. shit. Oh, for fuck's sake. Hey, dodged. Just want to see if I can do this. Hell yeah. Yeah, she took the power ring.
Forgive me.
He's gonna be able to double whoever he attacks except for Navarre. Probably get attacked by this thing, but not by stone hoist, or not by the quick rain. I mean, stone hoist is definitely gonna attack, but. She'll probably attack, friend. I'm not sure. Not sure what's gonna happen. Okay, that one just miffed the shot. Fucking hell. That sucks. Good thing I saved here. Yeah, I'm gonna cheat a little, but fuck it. That's shit I need to do. Actually, no, I'd not really... Not, I don't need to do that much. Alright. And the thing is, I actually was kind of worried that the fucking... the sniper would... attack. Or in crit, whichever unit was gonna be planted here. Let's see, so this guy's attack is 18. Consider setting up something. So you know, incidentally, Marth might be my best bet for sending out there against the sniper. Because he's got a high amount of luck, and he might get a support from Sheeta. A bonus from Sheeta. In fact, that's the only character he gets a support from. Thank you. I didn't even consider to use Marth, but yeah, he might actually be my best bet. Because he also has an insane amount of luck. I think he has the highest luck stat in the army, except for maybe... yeah, except for Rena or any other clerics, because that's what they're best at, is having luck. Oh, fuck. I hate that it lets you do that. That lets you fuck up like that. That sucks. I mean, it's not as bad as what the freaking... oh, I should have had him transform. Well, he can transform right now. But let's start moving everyone up. I might want to give that angel robe to Lind. Yeah, I'll give it to Linda. I don't want to move her further back. That'd be very, 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 very lame. Wait. That's right, he could just give it to fucking... Oh, he got hit. Talk shit, get hit. Enter, you fucking dick.
Hmm.
And now she can have 25 HP. She's probably gonna wind up being the unit with the highest HP. Only because I gave that to her. Can't just walk through the forest, they have to run around the forest to get into forest tile. Of course, why would he go for anyone else? Of course she dodged. So you know, she's not a fucking idiot. And then I just realized that I could just do this. Ouchies. Yeah, that dumbass archer is not gonna hurt Ban too much. It's fine that he can do that too. I kinda didn't want that, but whatever. Fed up with this stupid worthless scum. Thank you. No, I did not want to move her over there to trade. Yeah, Thunder Sword is basically like a weapon that does consistent damage for every unit. And consistent magic damage. Please, for love of God, hit him. Also, this is actually out of range of the cannon. I want Lynn to destroy that thing. Actually, since this one has attack status 7, she might be able to... Ah, shit. We're gonna have to... This guy does 16 and 14 damage to her, and this guy would do like 5. At least I think that's how it's gonna happen. On mathematics, you can do this. Able's gonna need. Wants to withstand its onslaught. Wow, Rena's really leveling up fast. Ouchies. Well, what do you know? Thank you. Receives 11 damage. Merrick's all the way back here, so I don't know if he's gonna be much help. To stay. I don't want anyone spawning. It'd fuck me over. Whoa. I mean to swing it around like that. Okay, dude's not even trying anymore. Just gonna wait there. I could do this all day. Weapon level is fine. Alright, let's see this finally. Yeah, this is Pale's castle. Ah, Pale's. At long last, Pale's. It's so great. I finally returned. There should still be many captive knights in the castle. I really want to help them. I understand. Amy's reinforcements haven't come yet. We'll charge into the castle. Yes, let's save. And we'll read the story. Many small kingdoms of this region were united to become the Holy Kingdom of Akaneia over 600 years ago. The founder, Adra the First, obtained 3 weapons from the deities and fought a holy war to unite the continent. From then on, the Kingdom of Akaneia became known as the Holy Kingdom, protected by the deities. The royal family were deeply respected. Recently, 6 kingdoms became independent, which was also thanks to the help of Akaneia. Right now, Prince Marth makes his first steps into the grand holy capital of Pales. Pales Palace. This place fairly important little... fairly important little place. Bosun the mage. Bishop. We're getting quite a few promoted enemies now. And to top it all off, all our units have to be mounted units. Now there is a... Now this is like a little prison. Units will start off with some units, here. And, yeah, I mean, obviously this looks like an interest, and I'm pretty sure we start off, like, around here. But, so the, like, this little area, got these mages. Got some promoted units over here. You got a Maneki. That's a vulnerary. But, yeah. Got all these thieves that are gonna be... They're gonna be running into this room to grab some treasure. Except for this guy. This guy's gonna probably be booking it. Yeah, now we got us a new mage and an archer. I think I'll be using that archer. Maybe. Depends on the promotion gains, actually. Because that would determine if I would think that there were... that I think Gordon's worth leveling more. I think so. I'm gonna end it here. think I'll probably do one more part, maybe one more part before, because I don't think it'd be good to end it, you know, to end it for, you know, the week here. Because, I mean, I'm kind of at a pivotal moment in this story. So yeah, I think, and I wouldn't want to let that wait for like 2 weeks. I don't want to sit on that for 2 weeks, so I'll end this here, but I'll do some more, probably over the weekend, I would have to assume.
I feel that.
Yeah, until then, hope you enjoyed this part. And enjoy the other stuff I'll be doing this week. And other than that, you know, happy holidays. Yeah. That's all I have to say. Very well.